Good afternoon and welcome to our Term 4, Week 6, Whole School Superhero Assembly. Mansi will now join us for the acknowledgement of country.
We acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, of the Darug Nation, where Aboriginal people have performed age-old ceremonies of storytelling, music, dance, and celebration. We pay our respects to the elders past and present, and we acknowledge those of the future, for they will hold memories, traditions, and hopes of Aboriginal Australians. We must always remember that under the concrete and asphalt, this land is, was, and always will be traditional Aboriginal land.
Thank you, Mansi. In a moment, you'll be asked to stand to sing the school song. Please stand quietly. Please have your hands by your side and feet together.
Join me after three. One, two, three. Seven Hills Westerners ask, may we value friendship, loyalty, and tolerance. Let service, honor, and wisdom be our companions as we strive to become great leaders, students, and citizens, worthy of our school and country. Thank you. Please sit down quietly.
Thank you, Hayley. Miss Locke will now present the Kindergarten to Year 2 Certificate of Achievement Awards.
Congratulations to the following students. So from KM, we have William Vanella for settling back to school very well. Ariana for improvement in reading and writing. From KV, we have Ram for always trying his best in all that he does. Gabby for having a positive attitude to all that she does. And from KL, we have Lavish for always completing tasks to the best of his ability. Akshitha for using a variety of conjunctions in her writing. From 1G, we have Alex Cooper for the dramatic improvement in the presentation of his work. Jasmine for her insightful contributions of how she can use the seven habits. From 1N, we have Tabitha for improved participation in class discussions. And Varun for improvement in his handwriting. From 2A, we have Jean Nutai for settling in so well to Seven Hills West. Lincoln for great improvement in report writing. And from 2R, we have Destiny for trying her best to read unfamiliar words during reading groups. Also from 2R, we have Caroline for identifying facts in an informative text. From K6A, we have Mahasvan for following instructions and completing set tasks. Also from K6D, we have Wyatt for settling in beautifully in his new class and for being considerate and friendly when interacting with his peers. And lucky last, we have from K6W, Edwin, for doing well in literacy activities. Congratulations to all these students. Let's give them a clap.
Can we please welcome Ms. Clements for the principal's address?
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to our week 6 term 4 assembly. And there's so many things I'd like us to celebrate. The first is that last week we had a wonderful Diwali celebration, and it was wonderful to see our children dressed up and to see the festival of lights all across our school, in our classrooms, in the staff room, as well as in our school foyer. And huge thanks to Mrs. Nalen for doing the beautiful decorations and all our classroom teachers as well. Now, I do know that we did have our lockdown on Friday and we had some deep cleaning. I'd like to say thank you for your understanding as some of us return to face-to-face teaching and some of us return to our remote learning program. I want to let you know that your teachers are working very, very hard, not only to prepare your quality teaching and learning programs, but also to start writing your reports. And those reports will be coming out in week 10 of this term. Now, boys and girls, there's something I want to share with you. I'm really excited about all of the children who are going to be receiving their Positive Behaviour for Engaged Learning superhero badges at this week's assembly. And I'm thinking that one of the reasons that they're doing so well in their learning, as well as being such great friends to their friends in their class, as well as on the playground, is because they're using the seven habits. And this week's habit is habit three. And I wonder if you know what that habit is. How about you go and tell your teacher right now? Is it habit one, which is be proactive? Is it habit two, which is begin with the end in mind? Or is it, by any chance, habit three, which is, I can't hear you, what is it? That's right, it's put first things first. So let's hear a song all about how you use habit three, put first things first. Time to present our superhero badges for the students who've shown how they're being safe, being responsible, being respectful, and a quality learner at our school. And the recipients of the Be Safe Superhero Badge is Subali Guha from 5C. Congratulations, Subali. The recipient of the Be Respectful Superhero Badge is Era Rout from 3P. Congratulations, Era. The Be Responsible Superhero Badge is going to Gabrielle Esquivel Alden from 3P. Congratulations, Gabrielle. And Be a Quality Learner Superhero Badges go to Julian Natividad in 3P, Govir Sembi in 3P, Mahir Sheikh in 34R, and Hayley Flowers in 36C. Congratulations to these students. And finally, how wonderful that we get to present gold badges at this week's assembly. Congratulations to Naaman Chahal from 4B and Subali Guha from 5C. Well done to these excellent students. They show outstanding learning and citizenship at our school. Well done.
Can go to school and I listen to my teacher. After that, at recess, I play with my friend Sana because she's the best friend ever, and I do my homework first.
So what do you put first, Jasmine, before you play? What is it that you're putting first?
First, I do my homework.
First, you do your homework, and then?
I go to play with my friend.
And why do you do your homework first?
Because it's important that if you don't finish it, then you send it to your teacher that everything is not done yet. And when the teacher checks it, that it's not done, you might have to finish it now because she might send you back.
Oh, so you're putting first things first, which is your homework first. And then you, what do you do next?
After that, when I have done my homework that my teacher gave me, I play with my friend.
And where is your picture there?
Here.
Can you point? Oh, what does your picture show?
It shows that me, I'm doing something on the computer like my homework.
Good girl, thank you. That is a perfect example of putting first things first, Jasmine. You're putting your homework first before you play. Good girl. Time. Mohammed, can you please tell Seven Hills West how you put habit 3, put first things first, in your daily life?
I do what my parents ask me to do before I do something I want to do, and do all the must-dos my parents required me to do.
Oh, so you're putting the things that your parents ask you to do first before?
Yeah.
Before the things that you want to do, is that right?
Yeah.
What are the things that you want to do?
Like when I go home, I might want to watch YouTube and play games, but before that, I have to do some things that my parents want me to do before I can do all those things I want to.
And what habit is that you are using?
Habit 3, put first things first.
Oh, so Mohammed, you use habit 3, put that first things first, to do the things that your parents ask you to do before you do the things that you want to do, such as playing video games or watching YouTube.
Yeah.
Oh, great way of applying habit 3 into your daily life. Thank you, Mohammed. Sana, what is the habit that we are focusing on this week?
Put things first.
Put first things first. What number habit is that?
Habit 3.
And how do you put habit 3 into your daily life?
I want to play with my friends, but
Wow. So the first thing that you are going to do, Sana, is?
My homework, then I will play with my friends.
So Sana uses the habit three, put first things first by completing her homework before she plays with her friends. Sana, that is a perfect way of applying habit three into your daily life.
What? I got another one.
Oh, another one?
Yeah. I love to play video games, but first I help my mom to finish dishwashing. Yeah.
So what are you doing first? You would like to?
Play video games.
But first you're going to?
Help my mom dishwash.
Aww. Your mom must love how you help her with the dishwashing before you play your games.
Yeah.
Sana, that is very thoughtful. That is a very thoughtful way of putting habit three into place into your daily life.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sana. Alex, can you please tell Seven Hills West how you use habit three, put first things first, in your daily life?
I do my homework before I play video games and to play on my iPad, which I want to do.
Oh, so playing video games is something that you want to do. But what do you do first?
Do my homework.
Why do you do your homework first before you play video games?
Because it makes it easier for me.
How does it make it easier?
If I do it when I get back home first, I don't have to do it at another time.
Oh, so you get it out of the way.
Yeah.
Is that what you do? You do it as soon as you get home from school and you get it away. Put first things first. Yes. Why is homework the first thing that you do before you go home, besides to get it out of the way? Why else do you put it first?
So then I don't have to argue with my mum about it.
Oh, because it's important?
Yeah.
Is it more important than video games?
Yes.
Oh, good job, Alex. Good choice. I like how you put habit three, put first things first, into your daily life. Excellent.
Miss Clements, Miss Gat will now present the Year 3 to 6 Certificate of Achievement Awards.
Congratulations to the following students for receiving their Certificate of Achievement Awards. From 3P, Ruby Wicks for going above and beyond in mathematics lessons. 3P, Jackson Flowers for diligently learning and applying new multiplication strategies. From 34R to Amin for great improvement in writing skills. From 34R, Gabrielle Ang for great improvement in the quick recall of multiplication facts. From 4B, we have Charamina for fantastic writing in her information report on the sun. From 4B, Scott Reed for trying his best in all writing lessons. From 5C, we have Emily for developing a well-structured and informative text about Mars. From 5C, Sahara Ahmed for trying hard when using the BOTMAS rule. From 3 to 6C, Shiza for putting first things first in the classroom. Well done on using our seven habits. Manisha for being an exceptional school leader and role model to her peers from 6C. Again from 6C, we have Thomas for increased participation and engagement in mathematics. Congratulations, 3 to 6 students. Round of applause to you.
Can you please stand quietly for the national anthem? Please have your hands by your side and feet together.
Australians, all let us rejoice. For
During assembly, an anonymous teacher has been looking for a class who were demonstrating the best assembly manners. This class is awarded with the privilege of having Teddy Brown in their classroom for 2 weeks or until our next assembly. Please wait for announcement of the winning class. Teddy Brown will be delivered to your class soon.
Thank you, Mansi. I would like to thank all parents, students, and teachers for attending today's assembly.